Good morning, y'all. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome if this is the first video that you are watching. Hi, my name is Lauren, and I am a third year first grade teacher here in Massachusetts. Today's video is going to be a fun one. It is actually Tuesday the 23rd, which means Thanksgiving is Thursday. I know it's kind of like split from what I have seen and heard from teachers around the country with like how many people have some school this week and how many get the whole week off for Thanksgiving break. Excuse the background noise, that's the heater, but it's 24 degrees outside, so I'm not turning it off. But anyways, we had school yesterday and we have a full day today, so two full days, and then we'll have 3 days off. But up here we also get a week off in February and a week off in April, so we'll make up for it later on. Anyways, today is going to be really fun. Yesterday we did our module assessment for math, which was literally the only like curriculum based activity or lesson that we needed to really get done this week. I did some long-term planning for the whole school year and paced things out and spread things out so that before breaks on short weeks like these, or even just like the 2 days or the day before winter break, before Thanksgiving break, Valentine's Day, things like that. So we have days throughout the year where we can do fun, just like crafty, exciting things together without it delaying or interrupting our curriculum pacing. I made sure we had some flex time, and luckily we had plenty. So anyways, today is going to be one of those just fun flex days, and I thought that would be a fun thing to share because a lot of what I share here on my channel is really like curriculum focused, and not every single day is like that. Granted, by far most of them are like that, but today is not. So I'm gonna walk over to my desk so that I can sip my coffee. And I want to talk you through some of the things that we're gonna do this morning. But on my way over there, I have some stuff I wanna show y'all. First of all, we made these scarecrows yesterday and I hung them up above the library. How adorable. I am back here by the closet in here. I have a stepladder. I bought one at Target and it has changed my life and my classroom. But anyways, also in the front of the room, if you can see across the top of the front of the room, I have an extra space for like wow work or student work display. Typically, you're not gonna be able to see it because of the light. Hold on. Over there along the bottom of the windows is where I typically display student work. However, I wanted to, I wanted to also be able to display fun things like crafty things and scarecrows and stuff like that. And not that I would never hang those on the wow work, but I like for that work to be more like standards based so that I can reference the standard and have it up. So anyways, yeah, those are the two newest additions to our physical space. Let's go take a seat, sip some coffee, and talk about what we got going on this morning. And here we are. Okay, so like I was saying, today is going to be a really fun day, but it also is kind of a little bit like important slash serious. Not really, but we have two big visitors at our school today. Our superintendent is coming to our school, and then we have a new superintendent this year, so he is going around to all of the schools to like familiarize himself and do some planning and such with administration at each of the schools. But he's also, I think, going to be doing some classroom visits, so he's coming today. And the mayor of our city is coming today, not for first grade, for a different reason with the middle school students here at our school, but like nothing bad, a good thing, an assembly, I think, or something. But I don't know, it's just exciting, like, ooh, two big official visits, and also the day before Thanksgiving break. So if they come on a classroom visit and we are doing watercolor turkeys, then that just is what it is. So speaking of, one thing I said I would never do, never, ever, ever do. If you watched my original classroom setup videos, I'm pretty sure I threw away like paints and painting trays, paint cups, brushes. Guess what your girl bought at Target last night? Paint, paint brushes, paint trays, because we are going to do a directed drawing of a turkey this morning, and then with like black marker, and then they're gonna have time to watercolor the turkey and like the background, and I'm so excited. So we're gonna do that today. This morning, typically we have like two academic blocks before they go to specials, so those are what I'm talking about when I say the morning. Typically it's foundations, which is our phonics curriculum, and then reading. So for foundations this week, we are reading a book from reading A to Z. We're doing shared reading. Yesterday we did the first read and we marked it all up, so we found suffixes and glued sounds and digraphs and all sorts of things, and we marked them up with the foundation's markings. I printed them all for the students, and I project a big version on the big TV so that we can do it together, and I mark it up there as well. One thing I love about reading A to Z is you can like write digitally on the books. So that was yesterday. However, it has a like predictable sentence frame. It says, "We on Thanksgiving," and it's about a family and what they do. So today we're going to do a second read. It'll be a bit quicker because we've already read it once. We've already marked it up. We're going to do a second read now, and then they are going to make their own page. I made a little thing on PowerPoint that just has like the same sentence frame. We blank, and I left a lot of space on Thanksgiving, so they are going to write their own page, illustrate it, and then I'm going to put it together in a Thanksgiving class book to put in our library for a little while. I just put it on the display shelf so they can read each other's writing. So that's what we're doing for foundations. And then I'm thinking during reading time is when we will do the directed drawing and watercolor turkeys. So yeah, that is what we are doing this morning before they go to specials and lunch and recess, which is our specials this week is STEM. Our new STEM teacher this year is amazing. They're obsessed. So anyways, that is our morning plan. Just a shared reading and a watercolor turkey. And then we will talk about the afternoon because the afternoon is going to be, it's going to be a hoot and a half. So, gotta get myself ready. I got 4 shots of espresso in my coffee today. I'm ready to go. Right now, I did not mention, I'm a little bit later than I normally am on Tuesdays. It is 8:18. Typically, we have to get here at 7:20 on Tuesdays for meeting, but since it's a short week and it's a holiday week, we didn't have that early hour in our contract this week, so we could get here a bit later today, which is nice. Anyways, really quickly before the students come in, I'm going to show you all my outfit because I love this outfit. And then I'm just going to kind of like wipe the tables, put some music on, and get ready for them to come in. I'll start getting like paper and black markers ready and such for our watercolor turkey project. All right, here we go. Outfit time. Thought I would bring y'all over here for my teacher outfit of the day, but I'm realizing now that my tables are so short that when I put y'all on the table, it only shows like the bottom half of my body. But anyways, my shirt is this little gingham. It's like a black and white gingham smocked baby doll top, balloon sleeve, so many details. Oh, we love it. From TJ Maxx. My earrings are from Target last summer. They're just like tassel earrings, but I have these ones in 3 colors because I love these. And then my Apple Watch, I have on black jeans, so I have to put $2 in the jeans jar, and black ballet flats. No brown booties because I'm wearing all black, so they wouldn't match. Anyways, yeah, I'm gonna get the tables ready, get all the watercolor paints ready, chug my coffee, put some music on. We're ready for a holiday extravaganza in our classroom. I'm so excited. We made it to specials. It's actually 10:30, so they have been at specials for 30 minutes. But as you saw, we started our watercolor turkeys. They did not yet finish painting them. So what we did was a directed drawing with pencil from Art for Kids Hub. We did the preschool version because I wanted the turkey itself to be very simple so that like the watercolor could be the fun, I don't know, like decorative part. So anyways, they did that with pencil, and then they traced their pencil with black marker. And then they started watercolor, but they're not done painting. So for the last 30 minutes, I was switching out the water because their watercolor water was like gross. So I was switching that out, rinsing the brushes, and I have trays on the table. Hold on, I'll show y'all. You can see that's the video that we used. This is like the example, and that's the one that the small child did. But anyways, they have these craft trays that are from the Target Dollar Spot over summer with the watercolor for the table to share, and then a water cup with all 3 brushes. And inside of the tray, I also put some paper towel for them to clear their brushes. Now I am gearing up for the afternoon. So this afternoon, I didn't mention the foundations like sentence stem frame thing went very well. I took all their pages and I stapled them together into a book that we titled Thanksgiving Traditions by Mrs. Kurtz's class. It was funny what some of them wrote because it was we blank on Thanksgiving, and some of them wrote like we eat candy on Thanksgiving, and I'm like, all right then, like it's up to you, whatever you do. Anyway, so we put them together. Now for the afternoon, when they come back from recess, they are going to immediately finish the watercolor turkeys, and then however long that takes us, and then into math until the brain break, which normally is like, I want to say it's like an hour and a half long. I feel like the turkeys are going to take us a good 15 minutes to finish. And then we are making balloons. So yesterday we read Balloons Over Broadway, and then so we learned all about how the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade started and what the balloons look like and everything. And then I told them that they are going to be a balloon designer and design their own balloons. So we watched just like a clipped version of the 2019 parade, I think it was, with just the balloons while they designed a balloon. And they finished the sentence, "My balloon is a..." Their ideas were awesome. We have, "My balloon is a Sonic, my balloon is a Pikachu, my balloon is a Hello Kitty." Like, they're going to make all sorts of things out of the balloons. So we are doing that this afternoon. However long that takes us, they're going to make their balloon. I have construction paper for like add-ons. So if they need to add ears, noses, mouth, I have lots of tape for them to use to tape things on there. I also have a helium tank so that the balloons float, because a big part of Balloons Over Broadway was the fact that originally he was a marionette man, and so the balloons are like a reverse marionette with a string, so you can control it from the bottom, so they have to float. So I bought helium. I did not realize how terrified I am of inflating balloons with helium until I just brought it out of my car and took the tank out, and then just like, that looks really intense, but we're just gonna do it. However, I also purchased 3 like fun balloons from Target so we could have some like bigger ones in our balloon parade. I bought an astronaut who was hanging in the front of the room, and y'all, if I pass out and don't pick up my glass from specials, it will be because I am blowing up this unicorn that is quite literally, like, I could use this as a sleeping bag. It is the size of me. Part of me wants to use the helium for this, but then I'm worried that I won't have enough to fill up all of their balloons, and that's more important. So I'm going to just blow this one up with, like, my lungs, with air, and I'm going to put it on a yardstick. So this one will be, like, on a pole, which is how, it like, originally they were on sticks, so it's still authentic to the Macy's Parade. So anyways, I'm going to blow this one up now, and then if I am still in the land of the living, I will check in with y'all before specials is over. Here we go. Wish me luck. If I sound like I am out of breath, it is because I am. Here is our beautiful unicorn balloon. Okay, so we have an astronaut and a unicorn, and I also bought the fire truck balloon, but I think inflating that one would actually be a health hazard at this point, so I am not going to blow that one up because I think I would actually faint. So we're ready for that part of the day. I think I'm gonna go test out one balloon and see how this goes. We can do this. It's just a helium tank. People do this all the time for birthday parties. It is nothing serious. We can do this. We can do this. We can do this. Here I go. Are there directions? Directions? Do you just twist it? I'm assuming you just twist it. Warning, contents under pressure. Huh? Oh, here we go. Rotate valve for full turns. Place balloon on nozzle. Gently press down to release helium. Okay. Okay. Here we go. Y'all heard it here first, folks. 4 full turns. Lefty-loosey, I'm assuming. Okay. Here we go. One, two, three, 4. Hold it in place. It's happening. It's happening. I think I'm gonna just make them this big because I do not want balloons to be floating, because I would actually think have a heart attack. Oh, this is stressful. Do it for the kids. Okay. And I'm just now realizing that I didn't get the string ready to tie it onto. So that was a half-baked plan, to say the least. Where's the string? Please have string. Oh, it's in here. I chose red because one of my kids is doing a Spider-Man balloon, so his balloon can be free and clean. Okay, of course it's all wrapped up. Because of course I'm not prepared. Dad, if you're watching this, I'm sorry. I know you paid for my braces 3 times. Oh. Low Santa. Okay. Where's the end of the string? Oh, this is just a hoop and a half, y'all. Where's the end of the string? Oh, here's the end of the string. Okay. I'm gonna tie you. Remind me never to become a children's calculator. And you know those people that make balloon arches? Could never be me. Could not be me. I don't think I had a fear of balloons until this very moment in time. Oh, it floats. Oh, she floats. Okay, I think I'm going to tie them to their chairs at eye level so that they can decorate them, but put some extra string hanging down so that when we're in the hallway, they float a little higher. This is gonna be so fun. Okay, BRB. I'm just now realizing that the singular red balloon tied to this child's chair is a little ominous, but that's okay. Hopefully they haven't seen it either because they're in first grade. But yeah, oops. Anyways, that one is ready to go. And look, I'll show y'all one of the little watercolor turkeys. He went really heavy on the watercolor, so it kind of looks like not watercolor, but that's okay. We're gonna do the backgrounds too, and then those will be drying. And then we will do our balloon design, and then we have we're still gonna do the genius hour, like the hour long iPad time. And then the afternoon for writing and science combined, I have the book Charlie Brown Thanksgiving, and we are going to have our own little Charlie Brown Thanksgiving feast, because if y'all haven't read the book or seen the like short film episode, whatever, cartoon, they eat popcorn, pretzels, jelly beans, and buttered toast for their Thanksgiving feast because they're kids and they don't know how to cook. So I bought Smart Pop, pretzels, jelly beans, and I bought Wonder Bread, but I also bought butter. I ended up leaving the butter at home, and we don't have a toaster, and like I'm not gonna bring a toaster. Some people would, I didn't. So we're gonna skip that unless they want a piece of Wonder Bread, then they can have it. But anyways, so we're gonna do that to end our day. We're gonna read the book and then have our little feasty feast, and then skedaddle for Thanksgiving break. But so far, so good. It's been a great day, y'all. I'm surprised I actually have some time. It's 10:47. I'm thinking I might go back through their designs from yesterday and maybe pre-inflate the balloons and tie them to their chairs. That way that part is done. Okay, I got 8 of the balloons inflated. I'm missing 3 today, so I only have 13 students, so which means I have 5 balloons left to inflate. The 5 that I haven't inflated yet, there was a little left to the imagination as far as like the base color for their design, and I don't want to inflate the wrong color if I don't have to, because I don't want to waste the helium. So I closed the valve on the tank, and those 5 I'll just have to ask them and inflate theirs really quick. But it wasn't an issue, it didn't take very long, but I am glad that I pre-inflated as many as I could. But now it is time for me to grab my lunchbox and head to the lounge for lunch. When they get back, we're doing watercolor turkeys and then balloons, and I think we're gonna parade them around the school like a little Macy's parade, and then we'll have our brain break and then genius hour and Charlie Brown Thanksgiving feast, and then I will talk to y'all at the end of the day. You guys, we made it. It is the end of the day. It is 4:15. So I've been here for just a few. Immediately after I got my last students where they needed to be at the end of the day, came back, got the broom out. I don't know if any of you all who are watching this have the experience of ever having fed first graders popcorn. I don't know what happens. They turn into goblins. More of the popcorn ends up on the floor crushed than any of it that ends up in their mouth, but that's okay. I just wanted to sweep really quickly, so I've done that. You guys, today was wonderful. It was amazing. I will try to include some pictures here of their balloons. They were so fun. It was kind of a long day. I wish I would have had like one more activity that I could have used as a like time filler for the kiddos who finished early, maybe like a color by sum or something along those lines, or like color by sight word, something, but that's okay. We did really well. We ended up joining up for the parade with the other first grade class at 1:30, and we walked around the whole hallways, and the second graders, we let them know about the time, so they were out in the hallway. They lined the hallway to cheer us on, which was just so, so fun. And lesson learned, I made the balloons too small, because when you start to add, if you're going to do this in the future, when you start to add things to the balloons, they get heavier, and then the helium doesn't hold them up as well, so they needed to be bigger. But like when I blew them up the first time, I was really scared, so I didn't want to make them really big. But fortunately, we had plenty of helium, so all I did was just blow up more that were bigger so that they could support their decorations. So that was good. I even had enough to inflate the fire truck with helium, and then I just hung up the astronaut and the unicorn like from the ceiling, and then all of those ones and the bouquet, they're like already starting to sink. Those were the ones that were too small to like hold up their construction paper decorations. So there is that. Oh, also when I got back, my school uses Class Dojo, which is, if you're a teacher, you probably know. If you're not a teacher, it's really cool. It's like social media just for your classroom. So we have a class story where like a feed where I can post pictures and things. And at the beginning of the year, I just asked for consent from all the families that their student could be posted on our class story. And that's private just for the guardians of students in this classroom, which is just really fun because then I can post updates. I call it our little check-in. So I did a check-in Thanksgiving edition and I shared some pictures with them. And then the thing is you can only post 10 photos to the feed in a post. So then I just spent some time privately messaging some photos to each of the parents of their child, their student, with their parade balloon and like what it was supposed to be, because some of them obviously, like, it's a little hard to tell. So I would say so-and-so with his Pikachu or with her Hello Kitty, and it's just so nice just to send out some messages. We just had the best day ever, and they thought it was hysterical when we read Charlie Brown. And that, hold on, I'm gonna move over here so I can sit down. My arm is hurting me. That works for me. So they thought it was so funny that we got to read Charlie Brown Thanksgiving, and then I told them, actually, we're gonna eat those things. Obviously, we skipped the buttered toast. I brought like a loaf of Wonder Bread as though I was gonna toast bread. No. But we had popcorn and pretzels and jelly beans, and y'all, I bought the Target brand jelly beans, and there were black ones, like licorice flavored, and it was the funniest thing just to see them. I told them, like, I warned them that they probably would not like it, and I said it's a really interesting flavor and most kids don't like it, but if you want to try one, you're welcome to try a black jelly bean. And they all wanted to try one, and it was so funny. But you guys, my heart is just so full. Obviously it was like a crazy hectic day, but in the best way. They got to just be little, and it's so nice sometimes just to let them be little. Like, they are 6 and 7 years old. We had a super fun day. So yeah, I'm just really, really happy. And that was a great way to start off our 5-day weekend. But my 5-day weekend is starting even better because I have some news for y'all. This is the last vlog that will be filmed with my potato, aka my iPhone 8, because the audio, I know you all have probably noticed, is a bit muffled and crazy. And then in order for me to fix that, I tried to like offset the background noise, but then it just makes it sound weirder. Anyways, last night I ordered for pickup an iPhone 13 that I'm going to use. I've always just used my phone for vlogging purposes. I don't have like a camera or anything to film videos with. Maybe in the future, as if I could like splurge on one, I might. But I also just need a new phone because my phone does not support all of the apps that I need. Like, I use Audible for audiobooks to and from school for my commute. Sorry, there's like someone standing in my window. Anyways, I can't even listen to them anymore. So I just have like 6 audiobooks credits that I can't even spend. So anyways, all of that to say, I'm picking her up. I've named her Elsa because she's white. So like ice and snow. So she is a white iPhone 13. So that will be what I film with in the future, and I'm really excited. Thank y'all for bearing with me. I'm hanging out, I'm lingering at school because I am picking it up from the Apple store, which is like nearby where I work. So I have a window where I'm supposed to like go and pick it up, and my window is not until 5:15. So I have some time. But I don't really have anything like to do. I've already cleaned up the classroom. I've already sent out all the dojo messages. My husband's cousin is looking for this toy for her daughter for Christmas. Christmas, and it sold out everywhere where they live in Chicago. And I just checked, and I think the Target nearby where I work might have one. So I'm gonna head there before I go get my phone, and I'm gonna take y'all with me. Alrighty, y'all, I am in the car. You guys can tell, but anyways, I got her. She is in here. Obviously, I have not switched the phone over yet because it's still in the bag and I'm still vlogging on this one. But I got it. I am so excited. I opened it up in the store just to like look at it, and I was like, oh my God, it's beautiful. And then because I had already like prepaid online, the man was like, oh, did you want to like look at any cases or anything? And I was like, I was like, no, y'all don't have anything that's bedazzled. There's not a sparkly thing in sight. I was like, I'm going to go to Target and pick out a case because there's a Target in the mall too. So I did go to Target, ended up finding one that is sparkly. So I am going to set that up when I get home, but I need to get on the road because my parents, they have a house up in Maine that they were up at, just like closing it down for the winter and everything. And they're headed back down south. So they're stopping by on their way back down on their drive. They're breaking it up and they are going to be here tonight. So I'm going to head home. I am picking up some Texas Roadhouse for myself and Jake, and then they're not going to be here for a little bit later on. So I'm going to go ahead and end the vlog here. Got a lot of things going on tonight, but next time y'all see me, I'm going to be in high definition. So anyways, I got to work on my makeup routine so I still look good with that nice high quality camera. Update. I did not find the toy that it said was in stock at this Target. They weren't on the shelf where they were supposed to be, but the lady like checked for me and she said, it does say it's like, we have some in stock. She's like, but if it's not on the shelf, she's like, it's on the sales floor somewhere. She's like, so that probably means that someone hid it. I'm like, oh girl. She's like, good luck. And I'm like, I ain't looking. So, I mean, I looked a little bit, but I didn't find it. So anyways, there's the update. I'm going to wrap up the vlog here. Happy Thanksgiving to you. I want to let every one of you know that I am very thankful for you all and for this platform where we are able to connect as teachers and share ideas. And I just really appreciate you guys. So happy Thanksgiving to you and your family. Hope you have a wonderful weekend. And if you have any questions, comments, anything at all, leave it down below, and I will see y'all in the next one in HD on Elsa. Ooh, ooh. Bye, friends.